Hey everybody, in this tutorial I'm going to be talking about how to create fire or magical effects. And this is a painting that I did, I think maybe a year or two ago. And I'm just going to create a new group and add two layers into that group. And then with the group selected, I'm going to change it to screen. And then the lowest layer you're going to want to fill with solid black. And then I'm going to go and make an adjustment layer and go to gradient map. And I have this fire gradient that I had made a while ago. And basically you want it to go from solid black to like a orangish and then to a yellow color. And then on the middle layer I'm gonna paint in pure white, and I'm just gonna select this cloud brush. Yeah, see, you have to paint in white, so I gotta switch it to white. And I'm just painting very lightly, trying to just add in some of these fire effects for his weapon. And the harder you press, the brighter it's gonna get. It's gonna go towards the brightest color on that gradient that you had created earlier. And so I'm switching back and forth between the cloud brush, and now I'm using the round brush, and I'm going and using the airbrush tool. And I'm just painting in these glows from the fire. And for the blade, I'm gonna use a little bit of a harder brush. Just want to get that brighter and get some sharper edges on that. And now I'm going to use this other, it's kind of like a cloud brush, but it's a little more textured. Switching back to the airbrush tool. Just trying to paint these in very lightly. I'm just kind of playing around with the fire trails. Now I'm adding in little sparks and embers and things that are coming off of the blade. And adding a little bit of a glow to some of those too, just for some movement and just to make it look a little cooler. So I'm having a little bit of a hard time being subtle about this, so I'm dropping the opacity down quite a bit. And I'm using the airbrush tool. And I'm taking the opacity back up to 100% to paint some of the fire glow hitting the armor, like on his arm and on his pauldrons. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the layer I've been painting on and I'm going to copy it. And the lower layer I'm going to go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur and increase the radius quite a bit, and then I'm going to drop the opacity down. And this will just create like an added glow around the fire. And then on the top layer, if you want, you can go and do something like Filter and Liquify. And it's going to be a little hard to see because you're painting in white. I'm going to zoom in on it. And then I'm just going to push this around a little bit to give it some more movement and make it look a little more like fire, I guess, and not so planned out. Like make it look a little more liquidy. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can see that. Getting the dynamics of fire flowing right can be pretty tricky, so I'm not trying to make something that's photorealistic, I'm just trying to give the idea that this is a fiery weapon. So if you don't like the colors or anything, you can just always go in and you can double click on the gradient map and you can change the colors of the gradient down here. You can add more colors too. Like I'm thinking maybe I can brighten this up so you can see that the sword blade gets a lot brighter. You can just play around with these sliders just to see if you can get what you want. Just try out different things. And this will work with pretty much any color. Like you don't have to do fire. I mean, maybe you're wanting to do some kind of a magical effect and not fire. So you just pick these and you can just change the colors to whatever you want. So if you want like a purple magical effect, then you just have to go and change all these to a purple color. And that's a quick and easy trick to creating fire and magical effects.